it's not Taddy Mason?
Dad, who the f*** is Taddy Mason?
Hello, I'm lilonostitches and this is my trip to Dallas. We began my trip from Austin to Dallas, and while we're in Dallas, we plan on seeing my sister, her fiance, and my best friend, Levy. We're going to see Pete Davidson together, and then we're going to Barbie World. First, we pass by Salado, and then I was doing my makeup in the car. Would you be surprised if I told you it took the entire, 2.5 hour trip to get to Dallas for me to finish my makeup? Then we passed by Bucky's, and my mom told me some really fucked up information about Bucky's. Then we stopped at Bucky's, and I finished my makeup for the most part. Then we passed by Hillsboro, which is where my aunt used to live, and she actually died on my birthday, and I was reincarnated as her. Then we passed by the Hillsboro outlets, which are also dead now. Fucking Lilo Land, I don't know.
How can you hate Christmas listening to that? Bring us figgy pudding. Well, you could say please, but you know, whatever, great.
Then I climbed into the backseat of the car to show you guys the cool Grinch sweater that I got from Bucky's, and also package my present for my bestie. Bougie this bathroom was inside this Sheraton. Side note, does anyone know if I can vape in here?
I got off on floor 13, no in between.
While inside the hotel room, I was watching Moral Oral and enjoying the gorgeous, gorgeous view. At the Majestic Theater, I grouped up with my sister, my brother-in-law, and my best friend, Lovey, to see Pete Davidson. He talked about SNL, his car crash, his stalker, and his experience with the Make-A-Wish Foundation. What happens next will shock you. I became Freethinkerland State Minister on Zimbaland. Yay! This is footage of me leaving the hotel. Here's some more hotel for you. While we were leaving, we stopped by the gift shop and I got this lamb, and turns out its name is also Lovey. Barbie World! And just like that, it was time to go home. But obviously, we had to stop and get some In-N-Out first. Also, take a look at that gorgeous sunset.
Commence, bird on a wire.
Let's ride. It
stitches know they can't catch me. Cute, sexy, and my ride sporty.
You know how Siri will tell you specifically which lane to get in? I feel like we might be taking that for granted, because it didn't always used to be like that.
You know what I don't take for granted?
What?
Digital navigation.
Instead of
a paper map.
Yeah.
Or instead of relying on my friend's directions, like Sandy on Brent's directions to get to Dallas, and she drove to Laredo.
Do you want to tell that story?
My childhood best friend and I have been best friends since we were in first grade. And in middle school, she dated this boy named Brent, which just involved going to the skating rink and couple skating on like Friday and Saturday nights. And, you know, making out in the corners. We reconnected. He moved to a different school district nearby, but we reconnected with him when we were about 16. We were all good friends. And that was in like 1985, 86. And then about 1990, 1991-ish, they started dating again. And he was moved to Dallas, and we lived in Austin. And anybody who is from Texas knows that Dallas is north of Austin. And she was gonna go visit him one weekend. He gave her directions, and I think he accidentally said go 3 hours south on I-35, because you know sometimes you just get your north and south mixed up. And this is before GPS navigation, so you either had to listen to your friends, you either had to write down your friends' directions, or there's no email, so it's not like they could email it to you or text it to you. You had to pick up the phone on the landline. And they had to tell you directions and you had to write it down, or they had to mail it, snail mail to you. So she was on the phone with him and he gave her directions and probably did say south. And so she wrote down south, go 3 hours south on I-35. So she left on Friday night.
Then keep left, merge onto I-35 south.
And drove to 3 hours. And then about 10 or 11 o'clock at night, I got a collect call from her in a panic. Collect call from Sandy, will you accept the charges? Yes. I'm thinking, oh my God, is she in jail? I don't know. I was freaking out. Crying. I'm like, what's going on, Sandy? She's also very petite. Sandy is a very petite girl. Blonde, blue-eyed, kind of an airhead, but I love her. Not super smart when it comes to street smarts, but you know, smart when it comes to book smarts. Anyway, she's bawling her eyes out. She's like, I'm lost. I don't know where I am. She's like, I can't understand like half of what she's saying because she's crying so hard. And she's saying stuff like, Texaco, I have to go to the Texaco because no one at the 7-Eleven spoke English. And I was like, what is she talking about? But 35 for 3 hours, and it literally took her to the border, to Texas. She went to the Texas border and she went so close to Border Patrol that she couldn't turn around. She had to physically drive into Mexico and turn around and enter right back into the United States. This is before you needed a passport. You really just needed your driver's license to get into and in and out of the United States. And she had to drive into Mexico, go on all the way into, I forget what, in Laredo, Nuevo Laredo, I think is on the other side, and you had to circle around and come back at the border, and then she stopped at the nearest gas station, which was the 7-Eleven. They didn't speak English. She had to go across the street to the Texaco, and that's where she called me collect from a payphone, because, you know, that's what we did. And so, yeah, I had to guide her back to Austin, but by the time, she's like, I can't go to Dallas. Like, she was so shaken up by what happened that she didn't end up going to visit her boyfriend, and I think they ended up breaking up.
We stopped at Bussy. Perfect for a toaster shaped soap.
Boja?
I'm so sorry this video wasn't out by Christmas like I expected, but thank you so much for watching.